And now, ladies and gentlemen, before we actually begin the humorous portion of tonight's show, I wonder if we might just have a moment of silence for the 43 elderly, mentally retarded Bolivian senior citizen volleyball fans who lost their lives this morning in a roller coaster accident just outside of La Paz, Bolivia. Apparently, they all stood up on a turn and went flying off into the cool, crisp morning La Paz air, and being heavier than air, landed in the funhouse. So I thought it might be appropriate for us tonight, as I say, to have just a moment of silence for the 43 elderly, mentally retarded, Bolivian senior citizen volleyball fans who went off for the goddamn roller coaster into the goddamn funhouse. And in case you think this is a moment of humor, a time to be joking, a time to be poking your neighbor in the ribs, I ask you to please put yourself in a Bolivian's place. In fact, put yourself in your own place. Put that place in Bolivia for just a moment. Think of yourself visiting Bolivia, watching a Bolivian comedian in a Bolivian theater, and he says that some mentally retarded American volleyball fans were tossed out of a roller coaster, and he wants a moment of silence. And you're sitting next to some Bolivian jack-off who's giggling through his nose. Might I say you'd be highly pissed? Might I add, rightly so. So, ladies and gentlemen, please, let us consider the many grieving Bolivians in our audience tonight. And let's check that very normal human impulse to laugh quite a bit when another person dies. And let us observe a moment of silence for the 43 elderly, mentally retarded, Bolivian senior citizens. Volleyball fans. Not to mention the poor unsuspecting fuckers in the funhouse. Well, I can see this isn't going to work. But that's all right. That's all right, because I don't know what to do during a moment of silence either. I don't know what to do during a moment of silence. What do you do during a moment of silence? What do they want? What do they expect of me? Do they want me to pray? They don't say that. If they want me to pray, fuck them, let them ask. I'll pray, but goddammit, you gotta ask me. They don't say that. They issue no instructions whatsoever. You go to the baseball game, you go to the football stadium, and they'll say, ladies and gentlemen, 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 we would like, 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 a moment, silence, 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 silence. I don't know what to do. Sometimes I have evil thoughts. Usually I wind up counting the pimples on the neck of the man in front of me. Looking for a whitehead with a hair growing through it. Or sometimes I'll find myself staring at the huge but perfectly formed breasts on the woman in the row in front of mine, rising and falling softly in the late October afternoon sun, and my thoughts turn gently romantic. Wow! Look at the knobs on her! What fucking knobs, man? Knob City, USA! I think I'm gonna go down to the refreshment stand and buy myself a weenie and conceal it in my pants. And then come during the halftime activities, I'm whipping out the weenie. Then I'm gonna eat the weenie and force her to watch me. Nah, she probably wouldn't understand. It's my way of asking for a date.
Well, your imagination runs away with you.
I don't know what to do during a moment of silence.
And why is it silence? What is it silence they want for? I mean, after all, the man, whoever it is we're honoring, is dead.
What good is silence? Guy's not gonna wake up now. How about a moment of screaming? Wouldn't that be more appropriate for a dead person? Ah! Would sure put you in the mood for the ball game. And why is it always the dead? What's this favoritism toward the dead? Fuck the dead. What about the injured? What about the injured? You always have more injured than you have dead in any good accident. How about a moment of muffled conversation for those who were treated and released? I've always wanted to be treated and released. Usually, I'm treated and detained. But that's private. That's personal stuff. I don't reveal everything. I'm not one of those who has to tell you everything. I will tell you a little something about my private life. Here's something you don't know. I never fucked a 10, but one night I fucked 5 2s. And I think that ought to count. I think that ought to go in your record as a positive achievement. Never fucked a 1. Hey, never got drunk enough to fuck a 1. Shit, you gotta be drunk to fuck a 1. Of course, some guys will fuck anybody, you know. Some guys will fuck anybody. Hey, let's fuck her. That's a signpost, Bob. Well, let's go for it. Some guys will fuck anybody. Not me. Not anymore. Not since herpes and AIDS are going around. In fact, just to be on the safe side, I'm not even jerking off anymore. Well, I don't know where I've been. And you know, the other day, too, I got to thinking about bisexuals and thinking what an awful life that must be. What a curse it must be to be a bisexual. Can you imagine wanting to fuck everybody you meet? Think of all the phone numbers you'd accumulate. You might as well just walk around with the white pages under your arm. And you know, I've always wanted to work in a delicatessen just so that a woman would come in one day and ask me to give her some tongue. And I'd say, well, I don't get off till 4 o'clock. And she'd say, well, I don't get off at all. That's why I'm looking for some tongue. So far, I just haven't had the opportunity. Ah, time for a little relief here, you know. Da-da-da. Sure, sure. Sometimes I go like this. But then I stop. This has been one of those times.